Hi guys, this is Jason Gaber with Mount Baker Mining and Metals. And I'm here to show you one of our new hammer mills. This is a 16-inch diameter case, 12 inches across. It's run by a 15-horse three-phase motor. Here's the inlet chute. Look down there, you can see the hammers. There's 16 hammers, four rows of four hammers. And they discharge out the bottom. There's bars in the bottom there that are spaced to the size you want to discharge. This thing has spherical roller bearings set off the case, as you can see, and a little flywheel here on this side. Belts drive that side. But it's important to have your bearings set off the case so you don't have a bunch of water and grit getting into the bearings. A lot of guys will do flange bearings on the side of the case, and that just, they get eat up real quick. This hammer mill will take a 4-inch rock and turn it into about 10 mesh minus. And the advantage to that is, for a small pilot plant operation, you don't need a jaw crusher ahead of it. You can just start throwing 4-inch minus right down the throat there and down to a sluice or a table. Keep your initial startup cost low. And this unit altogether weighs just shy of 2,000 pounds. So it's a pretty stout unit. Here's a replacement hammer. It's about an inch and a half wide and maybe 3 or 4 inches long. It weighs 7 pounds. So here's the lid off the hammer mill. I wanted to show you that there's case armor in here. I don't know if you can see down in there, but all the way around the case there's plates that you can bolt on, so you can change out these plates when they wear down. So all the wear parts are replaceable, so the case doesn't wear out. Here's the inside of the hammer mill. Here's the hammers. It's about a 1 1/4 inch shaft they're mounted on. See down below there the bars. These bars can be spaced to whatever dimension you want, and you pull out the top bar there and you slide them all out this way, and you can replace them. The rotor spins about 1200 RPM, so all the hammers fling out and stand straight up and crush whatever comes in the housing there. This one will do between 2 and 5 tons an hour, depending on the spacing of your bars there in the case. Thanks for watching, and keep coming back for more videos. We got some more we're going to post here in the next little while, so stay tuned. Thanks.